Figure I'd do a little repair video of the JVC microsystem. The problem with this one is everything works. It's just there's no display. So we're going to have a look at it. The model number is... I have to use a magnifying glass here, so it's small writing. Number, model number CA-UXLP5. This is a 35 watt system. Like I said, there's no working display. As you will see. So let's going to open it up and have a quick look at it. Okay, we got the lid off. The whole back just slides right off. Nice and neat. You get the CD-ROM on the bottom. There's your docking station for your iPod. The backlight for all the fancy lighting that they have in the front. Digital amplifier, which is nice. It's doesn't really say on the board, but it's definitely a digital amplifier. So here's your power supply on this side. So I think we're gonna, I guess what we'll start is we'll take the power supply out, take the shielding off of it, and see if there's any bad components like caps or anything else before we get into the display. Okay, well, we're getting down to the root of the problem. This lead here, the gray and black, or I say the gray and red wire that goes up to the top of the backlight, that's for the display, for the power. As you can see, it's trying to light up there. As it sits on longer, it starts to come back, and it's the lead plugs into the board right about there. And you can see on the printed on the board, there's a bunch of voltages, 12 volts, minus 25. So what we're going to do is we're going to measure off those. And more than likely, we'll have to replace a few caps. I'm guessing it's likely a cap. So the reason why is it sits on, it starts to lighten up a bit more. So let's measure off the voltages and... see what we got. Well, the voltages are there, but these two caps here, the two small ones, are in line with the red and gray lead that goes to the backlight or the display. So we're going to try replacing those and see if that does it, because the voltage regulator is working fine, and obviously the power supply for the digital amp is working. So to make it easier for anybody doing a repair, I figured I'd point out the capacitor that I'll be replacing that's in line with the lead for the backlight or the display is this one right here, closest to the power resistor and the regulator. These two produce a lot of heat, so my guess is it's likely dried out. So we're just about to pop that out and see if we can get any display working right away. And also maybe put extra long leads on it and maybe glue it over here somewhere far away from this, because it produces a lot of heat as soon as you turn it on. So this whole area gets hot. Got two more power resistors there, so we'll see. Okay, the cap is 100 UF. I think it's a 16 volt 100 UF, and it was in line with the display lead there, so I did end up pulling one of the legs out of it, and it doesn't look like there's any dampness in it at all. I'll cut it open and see what it looks like. Yeah, definitely don't need a tester to tell me that this thing isn't dried out. It's bone dry. So let's replace it and see what the result is. Okay, now I'm starting to see why that cap did dry out. This has a clock. And as soon as you plug it in, even when it's in standby, it's on. So that regulator is running 24/7. So that would dry it out. So I got a new one in there now. And I guess I'd show you what happens when you plug it in. we have a display. Sweet. Not bad for $13. There you go. Nice and bright. Nice. Now I can dock my pod. It's connecting, authorizing, and it's all good to go. Sweet. So, I hope that helped. One simple cap, which is 16 volts, 100 UF. It's not an uncommon cap, but that poor sucker just couldn't take the heat. So I hope this helps you guys. Someone's got the same model with the same issue, which they will. I'm hoping this video helps you out. Later.